Good day, everyone. I am Teacher John, your teacher for today. So, our lesson for today is about electrical materials. So, electrical materials are developed and constructed for special purposes, such as, number one, to control the flow of electric current in an electrical circuit, and number two, to carry electrical current from the source to the load or current-consuming apparatus. And number three, to hold and secure wires to its fixtures inside and outside the buildings and houses. And the last but not the least, it protects the houses, the buildings, the appliances, and instruments from any destructions and damages. And I will present to you the most commonly used electrical materials, and they are the following. Number one is convenience outlet, a device that acts as convenient source of electrical energy for current consuming appliances. That is where the main plug of an appliance is inserted and usually fastened on the wall or connected in an extension cord. It may be single, duplex, triplex, or multiplex, and could be surface type or flush type.
Ito naman ang halimbawa ng convenience outlet. Kapag gusto nating pagganahin ng isang appliance o kaya electric fan, dito natin ipa-plug. Ang convenience outlet na ito ay surface type or flush type.
Okay, number two, we have main plug. So, main plug is a device inserted to a convenience outlet to conduct electric current. So, narito ang example ng main plug. Saan natin karaniwang nakikita ang main plug? Sa mga appliances na meron tayo sa bahay. Number three, we have lamp holders. These are devices that hold and protect the lamp and also called as socket or receptacle. This comes in many designs and has two types, flush or surface type and hanging. Here is an example of lamp holder. Kapag sinabi natin flush type or surface type, it is mounted to the wall or up above the ceiling. Kapag sinabi naman natin hanging, makikita natin lahat ng sides ng ating lamp holder. Number four is a switch. It is a device that connects and disconnects the flow of electric current in a circuit. So, lahat ba dito familiar sa switch? Siguro naman sa bahay natin, marami tayong switch ng ilaw. Halimbawa, ito. Ito ay isang halimbawa ng switch na nakaklassify as hanging. Kasi, pwede siya at isabit mo lang kagaya sa switch ng electric fan. Yung mga nabibili nating electric fan. Yung mga maliliit lang, portable electric fan. So, meron naman tayong tinatawag na flush type or surface type, yung karaniwang nakikita natin sa mga bahay natin. So, kapag gusto nating buksan at patayin ang kuryente na dumadaloy sa isang appliances or sa isang device, gagamitin natin ang switch. Fuse. Fuse is a circuit protective device that automatically blows and cuts current when overload or short circuit happens. This one is an example of a fuse. Ito ang fuse. In case na may overload or short circuit, kusa siyang nasisira. number five is a junction box. It is an octagon-shaped electrical material where the connection or joints of wires are being done. It is also where the flash-type lamp holder is attached. This could be made of metal or plastic. Dito tinatago ang pinagdugtong-dugtong ng wires, usually galing supply, papuntang lamp at switch, para maiwasan ang aksidenteng pagdikit ng mga wires. Number 6 is a circuit breaker. It is a protective device used to cut current when trouble in the circuit.
Ito naman ang halimbawa ng circuit breaker. Pinipigilan ito ang daloy ng kuryente kung sakaling may problema ang ating mga electrical wirings. Paano nito napipigilan ang kuryente? Kapag binuksan natin ang circuit breaker, kailangan lang nating i-off ang switch na ito.
Number 7 is a utility box. It is a rectangular shaped metallic or plastic material in which flash type convenience outlet and switch are attached. Ito ang halimbawa ng utility box. Tulad ng junction box, tinatago din ito ang mga wires at dito inakabit ang switch o outlet. Number 8 is flat cord. It is a duplex stranded wire used for temporary wiring insulation and commonly used in extension cord assembly. Ito naman ang halimbawa ng flat cord. Duplex kasi meron siyang dalawang magkahiwalay na stranded wires. Karaniwang ginagamit kapag gumagawa tayo ng mga cord and extension wires natin sa bahay. Number 9 is electrical wire. It is also called as conductor. Electrical material that could be stranded and solid. Stranded wire is made of multiple strands joined together to make a single wire. Kagaya kanina, flat cord ay isang stranded wire. Samantalang, ang solid wire naman, ito, is made of a single strand of copper or aluminum wire. This is used commonly wiring installation inside and outside the buildings. Conduit or pipe. It is electrical material used as the passage of wires for protection and insulation. This could be rigid metallic, flexible metallic conduit, rigid non-metallic or PVC, and flexible non-metallic or corrugated plastic conduit. Ano ba tinatawag natin conduits or pipe? Narito ang isang halimbawa ng pipes or conduits. It is corrugated plastic conduit. Bakit kailangan gumamit ng conduits or pipes para sa passage of wires, para magkaroon ng protection yung mga wires natin na nilalagay sa mga walls and ceilings? Clamp. Clamp is an electrical material used to hold and anchor electrical conduits in its proper position. This one is an example of a clamp. Saan ba ginagamit ang clamp? Ginagamit ito para sa ating mga electrical conduits. Para maging fix siya sa wall, ito ginagamit. Ilalagay ng ganon para hindi gumalaw ang ating wires and conduits. Meron din tayong maliliit na clamps. Ito naman ang ginagamit tulad ng mga wires sa ating internet.
And last, those are the commonly used electrical supplies and materials. I hope that you learned something today that you can use in the future.